hear some small bats over here still. And here just at this rock edge, just want to move these things over here. Let's see, let's pick this one. Place it over here. Just rocks tend to be in groups. Of course, I'm not a rock expert because I don't often place them. So, sorry if I'm mistaken with the logic of how the rocks are placed. I do need to look into that someday. Here I want to place just a fairly big one. Like this, and I want to copy it. And let's just rotate it a bit. Place it down. And cover everything with our little mossy pebbles. This. Okay. Ah, here we almost forgot a spot. So for this spot, let's just do some small boulders. Don't be afraid to reuse multiple at the same location because that's what rocks are good for often. Let's pick this one again. Let's just set this on the edge, because it has a nice curve to it. And just copy this. Move it along here. And now to finish it off, just throw in some of our gravelly bits. Like over here. Okay. Now that's done. Over here we have some bigger parts. And over here I just want to place some fairly large rocks. This one only has half a side, so I just want to face away from anything that the camera can get near to. Like this. And because it might be hard to see, we will be using this one and not our little debris to like cover this up. There you go. So from distance that gives a nice silhouette. Maybe have some small things over here. Go. Maybe I do also want something over here, so let's again pick this one, because I just really like this one. Let's move this over here. Let's just move this up, rotate it a bit, and let's surround this also by some small pebbles. Here we go. Okay, so we have filled the spots. If we go to our camera views, here we have some nice rocks going on. over here we can just see them nicely laying around, and they will be better to be seen using lighting. And over here for this angle, I am not very happy with yet. So I think I'm actually going to move this up a bit like this. Yeah, that should be better. And then go out of our camera mode. Now for these pebbles, which are way strong, let's actually save our scene first. Save selected. And now let's go to our material. Strike this in here. And for our rocks, which are the top ones, I believe. Pedally riverbed, yes, so it's the top one. I want to go to, here's our displacement, and I want to follow this. And here is our displacement multi. It's set to 80, I want to set it to 60. And then just press apply, and wait for it to reload. Here we go. And that will make it quite a bit less, so that's nice. And also, just for the sake of this scene, I want to set the tessellation multiplier to 4, which gives us a bit more geometry to play with. And now I just want to save my material, because those are all the edits we need to do. There we go. And now also, as you can see, if you go to unlit and to wireframe, you can see that it has been tessellated quite a bit to keep up with all the rocks. And of course, this would be way too expensive to do for a game level. But for our purposes, it gives a really nice result, which is what we want. So, with that done, let's have a look. Did you forget anything? Don't think so. Okay, so before we want to start setting up our foliage, there's actually something fairly simple that you want to do. And that is, we want to go to our modes. We want to drag in a... Oh, looks like we don't have a cube. Never mind that. In that case, it will be a bit more expensive. But I will just be using my plane. I could make a lower poly plane, but for these teaching purposes, that doesn't really matter. Anyway, with this plane, I just want to scale it up big time. So let's scale it up 300 by 300 by 300. Should be something like this. And make sure to move it slightly down so that it doesn't intersect with our floor itself. And just drag in our floor material. It is still interacting with our floor. There we go. Yeah, so since we moved this down, of course, we do have this little place over here where it isn't really white. But from this distance, as you can see, you can never see that. And once trees are covering it, it doesn't really matter anymore. So this is quite nice to have this. And it still now has vertex painting on it, actually. So I could just go into here and just remove the green and the blue. Then we have this. If I then just go to red with a big brush, set the strength higher. I could like paint in some stuff. Although the vertexes are a lot farther apart because of course we did some scaling on this. But yeah, you won't be able to see this barely. So it will, from that distance that you will see this, it will just be a color. My plane is going a bit crazy. So I'm just going to paint in some random stuff, because why not? Here we go. And now, since I am working on vertex paint anyway, if I just go to my alpha and I set this on white and I select this plane and do this mostly for the pebbles and not for the ground intersecting here, because since this is vertex deformation by shader, foliage will not really catch up with the height difference that we have here. So in these cases, just do it with the pebbles. And then once the foliage is placed, we can just edit everything and paint the hills around the foliage or move foliage up and stuff like that. But like this, it gives you a nice height variation, as you can see. I also want to have that over here. Just to give some extra variation in here. And after this, I want to also have a quick look at the rocks to make sure I don't miss any spots. Like over here, where there aren't any pebbles around the rocks. And from this view, we want to make like a little path over here. So we will be changing that later on too. For now, just paint around it like this. So yeah, that gives already some nice variation into our fairly flat terrain. But in a reference, this terrain is actually pretty much flat. So that's why I choose to not choose a landscape, so that we can have a bit higher quality because it fits for this environment. And a landscape is pretty much the same thing to do. It's just one extra note in the materials, and on top of that, you won't have nice displacement like this most of the time. Or you need to make a very advanced shader, which I personally don't really have the time for in this tutorial. So let's just move this one up quite a bit. Here we go. Over here, also just paint in some height, which can also be pretty nice if we have some parts that are a bit empty. We can just have some height difference to cover up those parts, like over here. Now we have like this going on. Here we go. A bit around here. A bit more in here, like this. There we go. Oh, we already did this part. Okay, that done. Some final things to do is make sure that we did not forget any let's set the strength up to, let's say, 0.67. That none of the rocks are going outside of our pedal pads. Because that's just the way I want to do this. I think it looks nice if we have some pedals around it. It blends in better also. Like over here. Okay, now before setting up the foliage, we want to do a bit more painting. So let's start by actually painting in some gravel and some grass, so that we know where to place our grass and our foliage, so it will again be sort of a block out.